Hey everybody, it's Jane, and this is my take on Preisi's animal breeder. I saw this on Doc M's World Tour. The only real differences are that I used half slabs instead of full slabs, and I put glass blocks here. It's just a personal preference kind of thing. It's the same cow elevator, the only difference being that it takes a turn here to clear the water channels, which is what I added, instead of having the cows sitting by themselves in individual containers. I have them in water channels holding about 7 cows per channel. As you can see, we got about 40 cows right now sitting in the water channels. And also, I am in the 1.2 week 22A snapshot. So, and this is working. So that's promising for everyone working on breeding bays, thinking about the upcoming 1.3. There you can see the baby goes down the hole and triggers those two trapdoors. The only thing that I still have yet to do is to make it when the baby triggers those trapdoors, I want it to also trigger this to send down another pair. Somebody doesn't feel like having a baby cow. You can see right there in the snapshot, they're trying to combine the SMP, SSP, and it's... Now, I'm in single player, but it's giving multiplayer glitches, which I've seen pretty frequently in the snapshot. Mobs glitching through walls, slimes glitching through floors, things like that. Hopefully they work it out. Cow doesn't want to breed. You see right there, he just glitched through. He's still there, but... down the hole. Sometimes they just don't want to go. But as you can see, they get sent, the adult cows get sent to the cow elevator. They get brought up to the top channel, which is, they get blocked off by this trap door, and just like Preisi's trap doors, they're set off by this chain of torches. Same thing, I have this spec here that sets these trapdoors off. A lag spike. Well, that's about it. It's pretty much the same thing that Preisi had. Like I said, it's just got the water channels. And this is where the baby cows come out. So this is just a little something that I wanted to show you guys before I got into my Let's Play. Episode 1, coming right up. And we're back. As you can see, I'm starting off in a village. I did play for a little while, probably like 2 hours last night. I spawned somewhere over there, found this village, and I have since moved all of the villagers out of the village and into here. And this is Doc M's people breeding bay. And you have a single villager up top here with the doors. And then you have at least 2 villagers down here. And I guess the way it works is it tricks these villagers into trying to breed with the upstairs villager, but they can't, so they just breed with each other. I'm not sure if that's actually how it works or not, but I find that I pretty steadily will get a total of 8 villagers. And as you can see, there's 1, 2, 3, 4 here. There's one up there for 5. And then I have some 6, 7, 8. So if I killed off 2 of these, then there'd be 2 babies pretty quickly. And maybe asking what this is. Well, basically you have you can press this button to call a villager, which sends out a minecart. You can see him going around for a little bit of a ride until I have a empty cart detector. So if this was empty and the cart was empty, the cart would just sit there and go around. And once it detects that there's a villager in the cart, it sends him here, where, oh, that is nice. The new snapshot also has these double-priced sails. Actually, the interesting thing, I wonder what the old villagers have, because I saved them because they had some good deals. And they still have the same deal. So that would be that'd actually be pretty cool if you got one that sold you a diamond sword, and then you had one that did the diamond sword enchanting. You'd just be able to buy enchanted swords for emeralds, which, I mean, you can get emeralds for rotten flesh and various other things. But so anyway, this is, at some point I'm going to have the different villagers going to different areas of my home. And this is the blacksmith. Well, this isn't a... I would probably have him at the blacksmith area. But he is a priest. So we'll select priest. And it'll send him, as you can see, 1, 2, 3. The priest would be the third option. And we can come back here. And 1, 2, 3. Third option. So I don't really need him. I do want the minecart though. So whatever you pick is where it's going to send. You know, a butcher, blacksmith, priest, librarian, farmer. So you can send them wherever. And then I also have a recycle selection, which would be this last track, which eventually will lead to probably like a lava blade, and have the minecart come back here somewhere so that I can recycle it. Because minecarts are not cheap. Not cheap at all. Like I said, I played for quite a while last night, and this is what I got built. And this is just about all that I got built. I did a lot of caving. I managed to find a skeleton spawner over there, and there's a... I believe that one's a zombie spawner, and I found those and just pillowed up. Pillowed straight up. So what I'm going to do is I'm probably going to build my library right around here somewhere, my enchanting room. I'm going to build that somewhere right around here, and then I'm going to have, because this is really close to the surface. You can see it's right there. It was a really shallow spawner. So I'll have a mob evader, and I'll use a piston crusher to crush them to where they are a single hit, and so that I can farm XP, which now the maximum level is 30. It's not 50 anymore, so it should be easier to get high level enchanted items, tools and such. Sheep, come here, sheep. I'm also trying to figure out what I want to do for a sheep farm. I saw Etho's pop-up sheep farm, which I like. I'm very impressed with a lot of what Etho does is impressive. But it's a little too it's a little too costly. It's a little too showy. It's more for, you know, somebody who's not building their walls out of wool. So I definitely need to figure out something where I can harvest a lot of sheep very quickly, and have them regrow. But this would be my little mob villager selection. It's a very simple RS Nor latches. They're done in reverse, so when you select one, it actually resets that one. So what happens is every time that you press one of these buttons, all of the RS Nor latches get set. And then whatever button you pressed, which was this one, this is the one that gets reset. And I had to do that because of the orientation of the tracks. I didn't really have the space to invert the line unless I wanted to have it come out, which I really didn't want to, S it. I didn't really have the resource. Right now, I don't really have the resources to be doing a lot of extra track. So I just inverted it, in a way that works. And I had it built the other way first, and it was very messy, and this is actually a lot cleaner. It works very nicely having the reset switches up here as opposed to down on the ground, which is where they were. It's getting dark, better go sleep. But that's pretty much everything that I got done last night. I definitely need to do some more caving at some point. I do have a good start here with a decent amount of iron. Like I said, I don't have a whole. I didn't have this stack of gold. I got that after I'd built the this whole area. But right now, what I'm really needing is wood. So I'm thinking, and I started a reed farm so that I can get books, which now, because I'm in the snapshot 1.2 week 22A, now I'm gonna need that cow farm so that I can make books, which I don't know how a lot of people feel about that. I think that a lot of people would probably be upset about the extra leather cost. Cows are not, I mean, you can come across packs of them pretty easily. I just don't know as a lot of people spend a lot of time harvesting cows. I don't think it'd be very easy to spend a lot of time harvesting cows unless you have some sort of cow breeder, which we, I just showed you guys. That's my intended design for a cow breeder. I'm gonna use generic bees, wheat farm. Works out pretty, especially since that I got a skeleton spawner right there, so I got a pretty basically limited, unlimited supply of bones for bone meal. So wheat shouldn't be a problem. You should be able to breed all kinds of cows to get the leather required, because it's now paper and leather, which I'm a big fan of a lot of the changes that have been made. So far, I don't like the SMP SSP combination. I don't understand why they're doing it. Just doesn't make sense to me. And with the SMP glitches now affecting SSP, I don't know, it's very reminiscent of the whole Diablo debacle, where, you have a single player game on a multiplayer system. It just seems to me like a flawed concept. A lot of people, you're trying to play Diablo single player, you're trying to log in, get an error 37, error 37, you're sitting here, why are you getting multiplayer errors for a single player game? Doesn't make sense to me, but I am not the powers that be. I haven't yet decided what I'm going to do with this section here. I would love to hear any ideas that anybody has about what to do. This stuff is obviously just temporary. This is kind of like my base of operations at the moment. I was thinking about just kind of like closing this off as a wall and then mimicking this wall here. Minus the glass, this would just be wool. And I was just going to mimic that here. I don't know, the reason I don't want to do that is because I've just started building and I'm already thinking about closing off an entire area. And I kind of want to expand. That's kind of like my big thing right now, like I'm doing a library over there. I haven't really decided where I'm going to do the wheat farm, the cow tower, the various other. I need to work out some sort of permanent reed farm, which I think I might do near the cow farm, because now that books take paper and leather, that would just make sense to have them together. The other cool thing is that you get Generic B's wheat farm right next to the same concept in a cocoa bean farm, and that gets you chocolate chip cookies all the time. And who does not like chocolate chip cookies, especially now that they heal? I think it's two hearts instead of one, or two hunger haunches instead of one. I'm not sure. I'm sure they'll probably change it before 1.3, but. Last snapshot I was playing on, there was a glitch where the mobs were not showing the appropriate skin. So sheep that didn't have wool on them would appear to have wool. Colored sheep would appear to be white sheep. Villagers, regardless of what profession they were, they would appear to be farmers. It'd be interesting to see if that was fixed or not. It appears that that is the case. I haven't seen any of the erroneous skin problems. It appears that these guys are all not farmers, so. And I know that these guys aren't farmers. How's it going, buddy? So we'll have to see. Temporary little bit of a pumpkin farm I got going on. Yeah, so at some point I gotta clean this all out, get rid of all that. And that's the basic plan. Not really sure what I'm gonna do tonight. I think two things that I really need to get a grip on are wood and wool. It seems already that those are going to be two of my primary building materials. So, I have a lot of space here. It's pretty wide open. It's a plains biome, as you see. So I'll probably get some trees going over this way. And I don't particularly enjoy listening to the sheep all of the time, so I'll probably get a pen, just a really large. Can't decide if I want to just do one large pen that you have to actually go into in order to harvest the wool, or if I want to just do like single rows. I don't have any fence posts on me. Grab some fence posts here. So I don't know if I want to do a big pen or if I want to do like individuals and just get the kind of like the sheep in their own. And I'm running out already. What do you know? I just have a bunch of like individual shells, cells for the sheep, so you can harvest them and you don't have to, and then you'd have, like another row. have another row there. So you could basically, you could just come down one side and shear them, collect the wool, and then you could just come down the other side, do the same thing. I think that's probably what I'll end up doing. I'll have it somewhere over there. And then I'll just have a bunch of trees just willy-nilly over here somewhere. I don't know. I haven't really decided. I guess we'll have to wait and find out. I think I'm definitely going to have to take a break here pretty soon. Yeah, I definitely think that they fixed that skin glitch. Which is nice, because it's infuriating when you're trying to shear a sheep that appears to have wool on it, and it really doesn't. As you can see, I have lots of just cows and pigs and sheep all over the place here. Like I said a little while ago, I just started. You know, this is a couple hours last night that I just kind of threw in. And then I showed you guys earlier my cow breeding bay. I'm going to build that at some point. The nice thing about that design is how cheap it is. You know, trapdoors, redstone torches, very, very cheap. I think there's maybe one repeater and one sticky piston, which that's a big thing for me right now is sticky pistons. I know where there's some slimes. Like I said, I did some caving, ran into a couple slimes. I don't know if it's a glitch, I don't know if it's a change, but it appears that when you kill a big slime, last night I killed a couple of them, they no longer split into smaller slimes. So you find a real big slime, you kill them, they split into the four, then you kill those, they split into 16, so on and so forth. Last night I killed two big ones and they just died and dropped slime. They didn't split. Medium ones too. I killed a couple medium ones. They died, didn't split. So I don't know if it was a glitch. Maybe it's different now. Like I said, last night I was in the, what was it, 21B snapshot. Now I'm in the 22A. So we'll have to see. We'll have to see if the slime split or if they just, if that was something that they had changed. I hope not, because that makes slimes even more rare. That's one of the nice things. You find a big slime and you knew you were in for a good slime haul. But that is not necessarily the case at the moment. So we'll have to see. Definitely trying to think about where I want to put cow farm, well, the cow tower breeding bay, the wheat farm, the various other farms that we're going to have to get going here. I don't know why, but I like to chop trees down from the top down. When the jungle biomes came out, I was ecstatic, because it's like you climb to the top of a jungle tree and you can just harvest that whole thing right down to the bottom in one. It's so quick. I know there's a couple of my friends who didn't really like the jungle trees, felt that they weren't as fast, but I definitely have to disagree. Climb to the top of a jungle tree and chop downward. But yeah, I'm open to any suggestions that people have about where to put some things, what to build. This is where I was caving. There was a wheat farm here, from the villagers, and there was just like a hole in the ground that led. You can see that I kind of filled it in a bit, but just led to this huge ravine. It's just enormous. And I don't, I'm, this is one of the new giant biome, world modes. So maybe that has something to do with it. I don't know. But the ravines are huge. I mean, it's like three ravines intersect into one. It's crazy. I love it. Gives you a lot more stuff to explore. Get some torches here. Definitely missing my Optifine on the snapshot, but I certainly... As you can, like I said, I played for like 2-3 hours last night, and I did a lot of caving, a little bit of building, and you know, you can see that there's a lot of this that's still not lit up, that's not explored, because it's just so massive. Here I am with stone pickaxe, and I got like a 2 stacks of iron. I don't know about me sometimes. So. That's where we're sitting. Looks like there's still some lighting glitches, which I suspect will be an ongoing bug problem for a long time. It seems like the more that they do, the more lighting problems there are. Yeah, here you can, as I was saying, it's just massive. It's huge, like, you know, it goes down there, goes down there, goes down there. And then it even, like, there's, I think, 2 ravines that it intersects. And there's a abandoned mineshaft around here somewhere that I found when I found those spawners. Thing just goes forever and ever. Let's see if we can find my way back to the surface here. Well, I think this is where I'm going to leave you guys. I'm not entirely sure how long this episode is, but, you know, it's my first episode, so we'll have to hopefully keep this going. I'm not sure what kind of reception that it'll get. Like I said, we'll have to wait and see. I guess that's the hard part, waiting. Until next time, guys, take it easy.